Now, West Nile virus is an encephalitis, causes an encephalitis type disease, but it had never been found in the Western Hemisphere. Okay? And this is several years ago now. And the way it started was that birds in the Bronx Zoo started to die, and they had an encephalitis type infection. And a vet in the Bronx Zoo sent her tissue samples to the CDC, Center for Disease Control, and they were pretty overwhelmed because the CDC never has enough money to do everything they have to do. And they sort of said, yeah, we'll get to this. You know, birds are dying. Well, at the same time, there was an increasing number of human patients in New York City which were exhibiting and dying of an encephalitis-type disease. People thought it was the mosquito-borne St. Louis encephalitis virus. They didn't really know. And the then chief of emergency management in New York City managed to co-opt the entire supply of OFF. OFF is something that kills mosquitoes and flying bugs. And he just sprayed OFF all over the city, and he stopped the epidemic cold. Meanwhile, the lady vet at the Bronx Zoo was still trying desperately to find out why her birds were dying, waiting to hear something from the CDC, and the weeks were going on. And she happened to go to a wedding on the West Coast, and sitting next to her at this wedding was a virologist, and not particularly interested in dancing. They started talking about, you know, this odd thing that was happening to her birds at the zoo. And he said, look, why don't you send me some of your tissues and I'll try to figure out what you've got. And that's what happened. He very rapidly identified this as West Nile virus. Now, everyone's initial reaction was this couldn't be. We don't have West Nile virus in the Western Hemisphere. But at about that time, in Fort Collins, the CDC had in fact identified this as well as Fort Collins, as West Nile virus. It just took too long. And this was our first experience with trying to rapidly identify something new. Now, interestingly, concurrently, while all this was going on, an Iraqi defector had reported that Saddam Hussein was developing a strain of West Nile virus as a biological warfare agent and was preparing to release it. This was never confirmed. Was this a BW event? We don't know. Did this come into the United States on a 747 that a mosquito happened to crawl into? We don't know. We don't know the answer. But what's important and what one has to remember is anything we do to identify a new outbreak will be relevant to no matter what the source is, malevolent or natural. The problem is to understand what we've got and to rapidly understand how we can analyze these things and identify the agents.